नमस्कार, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल द व्यूअर्स. दिस इज अर्पिता श्रीवास्तव राय वेलकमिंग यू ऑल ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ द होल ग्लोबल फैमिली टू दिस नोबल इनिशिएटिव ऑफ हैप्पी कैरिकुलम नीड एंड इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय द आत्मनिर्भर भारत इन कोलैबोरेशन विद प्रक्रमिका इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मस्कट ओमान. We the change makers of the Atmanirbhar Bharat strive for the excellence in our program and yet present you with this topic of the happiness curriculum need and implementation strategies by Dr. Beni Verghese along with our chief guest Dr. N. Basungi, Dean School of Home Science, Avinash Lingam, Institute of Home Science and President of Home Science Association of India. Well, there is a very beautiful quote given by Mother Teresa. Everyone can rise above their circumstances and achieve success if they are dedicated to and passionate about what they do. Well, before taking much of your time, let's start the program. And we will have our traditional auspicious lamp lighting ceremony, a tribute to the Mother Saraswati, the goddess of knowledge, blessing all humanity by our chief guest, Her Highness Dr. N. Basungi. Can I request our IT team to please have a virtual outlay for our audience?
I request Akila to share the screen. Thank you.
Thanks. I find it to my pleasure to address you people, you, the young minds of today and the responsible citizen of tomorrow. So I feel really privileged and extend my warm welcome to all the dignitaries, faculty members, teachers, students, and the members of the Institute of the Avinash Lingam to be here with us. As we look ahead into the 21st centuries, leaders will be those who empower others. Leadership is the capacity to transform vision into a reality. And I'm very proud to say that we have an example in front of us with the presence of our chief guest, a lady who have a legacy to leave behind. Legacy in the form of a successful social entrepreneur. She's an asset to the society, a holistic being, and a willingness to embrace the people, to motivate and inspire, to give back to society. not taking much of your time, kindly allow before I call her for the ceremony to give her a presidential speech. Would like to brief our viewers with a short profile of our chief guest. Allow me to give her introduction, please. Dr. N. Vasungi, MSc, MBA, MPhil, and PhD, Dean, School of Home Science, Professor, Textile and Clothing, Avinash Lingam Institute of Home Science and Higher Education for Women in Coimbatore. Her specialization has been in the field of textile management, extraction of co-friendly fiber, natural dyes, technical textile, medical textile, while having 30 years of experience in hand. Well, she has a very long list, and I'm sure that due to the constraint of time, I would be really shorting it up for our viewers. So the key points which I would like to highlight would be her joint publications, where internationally, 42 of her journals and national 27, and she's been also been a co-author for 35. Now, as far as the research and academic events, she has conducted near about so many conferences and the events and the seminars and workshop too, in which 10 she has organized internationally, 22 national and state level seminars also too. Well, not taking much of your time, she's also been guarded with a lot of members of the other association and been an expert committee member too. Examiner for PhD evaluation, institute building, significant contribution to universities in many fields. And, some of the key points that I would like to highlight is her awards and honor, like Sir J.S. Bose Memorial Award by Indian Institute Monitor, Distinguished Accomplished Award in Textile by Texas Tech University, and certificate of appreciation which she has received from Tamil Nadu Institute, AIDS Control Society, and State Blood Transfusion Council, implementation of small saving schemes, certification appreciation from painting with fabric pens, with a lot of her strengths and innovations and her area of specializations, especially techniques in printing, dyeing, textile designing, advanced fabric construction, textile testing, textile quality analysis, apparel marketing, and technical textile. Significant contribution is expressed in terms of National Mission on Education through ICT, development of e-content in home science in PG level, UCG, SAP, DRS, and MOU with other educational research institute. So before taking much of time, let me welcome our honorable chief guest, Dr. N. Vasungi. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am, for your introduction. Thank you for calling me as a to give a presidential address again in this Aadmi Bharat team. It's very happy and proud to be here because all are learned person. I'm happy to encourage the students, teacher, and others who are participating in this. It's very nice because from the childhood, I'm motivated by the teachers and elders. Then only I come to this level. So this is very nice of you, me to be part of this webinar. So I'm very happy. And I'm honored and happy to be the amongst you and at this inaugural session of virtual program on happiness curriculum needs and implementation strategies organized by Aadmi Bharat team and SEERT, Delhi State Council of Educational Research and Training, New Delhi. I'm delighted to these faculties across globe from Middle East and Indian schools, especially from Muscat, Dubai, UAE, Oman, and Indian states, participants in all one platform, and in all inculcates the knowledge sharing culture among the entire fraternity of education in the country, thereby contributing to the development of nation and worldwide. The knowledge sharing will surely improve the teaching learning process to the academician and policy makers and benefit the society. Education has a longer purpose to serve, and hence it cannot be been seen in isolation from the dire need of today's society. Educators and schools across the globe are realizing the needs for a wellness lesson for school children. Here I would like to highlight one of quote given by our nation father Mahatma Gandhiji is, happiness is when what you think, what you say, and what you do are in harmony. Mahatma Gandhi. Happiness has now become a part of the global policy agenda. In 2011, the United Nations General Assembly recognized happiness as a fundamental human goal in the resolution as happiness towards a holistic approach to development. Many report also reflect schools and prioritize learner well-being have the potential to be more effective with better learning outcomes and greater achievements in learner. All children are born and raised in different situation, and the environment in which children grow up today is inconsistent and unstable with constantly changing social and economic dynamics, making it hard to imagine that the future in which children of tomorrow will live and work turn out to be like. Many children grow up in the confines of multi-storied apartments with excessive exposure to unguided electronic media, unlimited screen time, and little orientation to the natural world and society. Many others grow up in different circumstances with little nourishment for the body and the mind. Some not even have seen a book or a toy until they go to the school. In both cases, there is either an overstimulation or a deficit in these areas with our students, leading to a psychological crisis that is spinning out of control. The challenges in the school system have gone beyond poor learning standards and academic results. In this context, I want to tell one thing. I asked in our auditorium and many, many colleges and schools, wherever I go, who are happy, they are not raising the hands because they are thinking happiness is different from what they are living. The needs are fulfilled whenever they need. The target is there, they will go for a further movement. So they are not having that target because all parents are fulfilling their target or whatever they need. They are giving whenever they need. So those days, that is not like that. When we are doing many things or many achievements in sports or academic, they used to tell, still you have to read like that. The reading habit, the distraction is less when I was small. Because nowadays, the media is disturbing us in many ways. So not only us, the students, small one. Because from the 1 year onwards, they are giving mobile to them for playing. Otherwise, they cannot give sometimes to the children, the infants. So they have to, parents and teachers have to give more time in speaking with them. So that is the main reason for less happiness in among the children. In this context, we can see an increasing emphasis on building awareness and mindfulness among us learners around the world. Mindfulness is paying attention in a particular way on purpose in the present moment, not judgmentally. It is a practice of bringing attention to our thoughts, feelings, and action as they arise from moment to moment. Mindfulness is rooting to the science of cognitive neuroscience and child development. It is a highly researched and proven practice by neuroscientists to enhance attention and self-regulation. Further, mindfulness improves decision-making, leads to greater emotional stability, abstract planning and less reactivity. Regular short practice of mindfulness rewires the neutral connections of the part of the brain which enable us to feel happier, calmer, less anxious and stressed. I congratulate all the students, parents, teachers, principals and education department officials of Delhi for this unique initiative. I believe this effort will open new doors of reform in the field of education at a global level, although there is a strong humanitarian and social basis for the introduction of the happiness curriculum. It is also a scientifically designed course that is proven to be very helpful in keeping children mind focused on work, them living harmoniously with family and society, but not importantly developing a holistic outlook and perspective on life. I have no doubt that the deliberation at this program would be of great value in bringing new thoughts and perspectives to assessing the contours of the challenges to be addressed in the future. I congratulate team Admin Bharat for their unique initiative on vocational learning process, especially the pioneers Mr. Pratip Singh and Mrs. Gayatri Narasimhan, an entire team of Delhi, Lucknow and Chennai, who are part of public policy, legal education, health, IT, environment, research and internship development programs. Even during pandemic, they conducted various events contributing effort up skilling people on vocational skill. They are working extensively on reaching out to people and masses for learning and educating new concept on making them self-reliant across India. Let me conclude by wishing all success. I wish the program a grand success, all the best of Adminar team and all the participants from different countries. Thank you very much for your patient hearing. Thank you.
Wow, what a fabulous speech. I'm really, really delightful, ma'am. And I'm sure all our viewers will be excited to hear you once again, thanking you for giving your precious time, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
And I would say one thing, you know, to our viewers, if your action inspires other to dream more, learn more, do more or become more, then I must say you are a leader. And ma'am, you are a true leader. You have set in that benchmark and we all look forward to you. Well, I strongly believe that the future of the nation lies in our next generation. And I want to instill the life skills, morale, and social values in our youth to prepare them for life. And I must say that you can't lead anyone if you cannot lead yourself. And who could be a better example than our convener, Mr. Pradeep Singh of the Atmanirbhar Bharat. So let me welcome Mr. Pradeep Singh for his opening speech. Welcome, Mr. Singh.
Pradeep sir, can you hear us?
Yeah, now I can hear you. Thank you. Yes. Thank you, Arpita ji. Namaskar to all. And thank you to my chief guest, Dr. Vasugi, under whose leadership and under whose mentorship we are guiding people, we are guiding our interns, we are guiding our academicians to go for vocational learning and also to other academic programs. Not only in India, now we are working with our research kind of things in overseas too, especially Muscat, Oman, Abu Dhabi, Australia and Canada. I must say that Madam has taken certain great initiatives with her institutions too. And today she mentioned some of the good, of course, previous thoughts said by Mr. Mahatma Gandhi, father of nation, that happiness is a state of mind. We all believe on this and we all follow this. That is why we all are here today to find out the ways how we can implement our things in our schools, in our colleges, and in our institutions. Secondly, I must say that Madam has bring out that UN goal, which somewhere we have actually left out, which was administered in 2011. She has considered so many things into the happiness. She taken out those social emotions, how the social environment is, how is our psychological ecosystem is working. And very, very, you can say in a very brief way, she tell us what is actually lagging in our today's environment, how our happiness and how our target is being actually not making people to go for happiness kind of things. Our family legacy or our family target is being motivated to some other targets or even some other competitions. So this is how we are not able to prepare ourselves or our next generation to go for happiness. Today's session, we will be covering this actually particular paradigm, where we will be discussing how the mindfulness is and how the holistic development in consideration to happiness curriculum. Not taking much time, I must thanks again to our Avinash Langam Institute and Dean Dr. Vasundi and the coordinator Dr. Parvati P. Rao and other administrators, those who helped me out for reaching out to Avinash Langam. And of course, Avinash Langam, we are working with Avinash Langam on research and internship too. Thank you, Madam, and thank you to all from Avinash Langam. I request IT team to please present a gratitude certificate to our chief guest, and then we can proceed for next our resource person to come and deliver the lecture. Thank you.
I request Akila to kindly share the certificate of gratitude.
On behalf of our Atmanirbhar Bharat Vocational Learnings, we are presenting a gratitude certificate to Dr. N. Vasundi, under whose leadership we are today here, and we are doing our research and internship too with our interns. Thank you, Madam, for always guiding us and always mentoring us and embrace our learnings too, and making my team, those who are in my team, always embrace. From your side, I get a lot many embracement and a lot many knowledge to work upon the social causes. Thank you. Thank you for the same. Namaskar. I request.
Thanks, Pradeep, for your lovely speech. Well, now I would like to invite Gayatri Ji to take the proceedings ahead and teach our those persons.
Thank you, Arpita Ji. Namaste, good morning, and good afternoon to everyone present here. We are extremely privileged to have with us today Dr. Benny Verghese, a highly qualified student counselor and a highly committed to the needs of the students and parents, and extends all possible aid to empower the students and parents with the need of the hour, and his competent guidance promotes the well-being of the entire Indian fraternity within the confines of the school and beyond. He holds a PhD and an MA in psychology, coupled with a diploma in naturopathy, a certificate course in management and training for learning disabled conducted by Indian National Portrait Association, India, affiliated to its counterpart in USA. He's also certified for the administration and interpretation of Indian scale of assessment of autism. He's a certified career planner and a trainer of career planners of iDream Career Delhi. He's also registered with Rehabilitation Council of India. Dr. Benny didn't stop his academic pursuit and perennially updates his knowledge to hone his skills in all prospective areas for the betterment of the Indian student community. To name a few, workshop on communication training for children with autism spectrum disorder, workshop on autism, understanding students' behavior, behavior assessment strategies, workshops on inclusive education conducted by Vidyasagar Institute, Chennai, workshop on teachers' training program on learning disabilities by Dr. Anjali Modis Foundation, Pune, a certificate course in management and training for learning disabled conducted by Indian National Portrait Association, India, affiliated to its counterpart in USA, a certification workshop for the administration and interpretation of Indian scale of assessment of autism. After working in eminent academic institutions in Kerala, Dr. Benny was associated with Indian School Muscat as a student counselor since September 2008 to September 2019, besides being entrusted with additional responsibilities as student counselor in Indian School SEEP for nearly 2 years and as supervisor for Center for Special Education, Indian School Muscat. During his tenure in Indian School Muscat, Dr. Benny's initiative and contributions are beyond measure. The major activities in which he has been concertedly involved are the inclusion program at ISM and other Indian schools in Oman, coordinator of the SOP construction for inclusion at ISM, counseling and psychotherapy sessions for students and parents, aptitude tests, CBSE documentations, yoga club, and many more. With a long experience of working with a wide range of challenged children, Dr. Benny has built deep expertise in assessments, therapies, documentations, creation of individualized education plan for SEND children, remedial sessions for SEND children, and shadow mother and scribe arrangements for the SEND students as per CBSE norms. Dr. Benny provided effective teachers training programs at Indian School Muscat and other Indian schools in the Sultanate. The training program include inclusion challenges and strategies, classroom management of inclusion students, bullying, study habits, identify your learning style, charms and challenges of teenage, screening and remedial strategies for SEND children, and many more. Dr. Benny has been actively associated with CBSE telecounseling from 2014 till date. He has also conducted various sessions on pre-examination stress management for various Indian schools in the Sultanate of Oman. He also coordinated the career aptitude test for class 10, which includes both paper, pencil, and online exam. This is followed by result analysis and career counseling for both students and parents. To his credit, Dr. Benny has presented 3 scientific research study papers. It is also to his credit that we at R2B and Prakramika Institute were overwhelmed with a huge response for today's webinar. Without much ado, let me hand over the Zoom floor to Dr. Benny. Over to you, sir, and we are waiting.
Thank you very much. Am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah,
sir.
Yeah.
Yes. Thank you very much, Arpita ma'am, Dr. Vasugi ma'am, the Dean of Home Science Institute, Coimbatore, for a very elaborated happiness matters, related matters. Then Mr. Pradeep Singh, then Ms. Gayatri Narasimhan, who was my colleague, a well-wisher, always with me for every activities in Sultanate. Thank you very much, Gayatri ma'am, for the beautiful introduction about me. I don't know whether I deserve these things, I don't know. But anyway, now at present, we are coming to the happiness curriculum, the need and implementation strategies. Is there any disturbance? Everything fine?
Actually, there is a slight echo, sir.
It's from my side?
I think.
No.
My side is clear.
It's clear. Can hear. But yeah.
Okay. Shall we start?
Yes, please.
Now, happiness curriculum. is one of the implementation or one of the strategies developed by CBSE so that our students may be happy in the classroom and learn well. When we think about different challenges, both to the teachers, for example, they have curricula as a whole, how to teach. So NEP came, national policy came in, art integration came in, now happiness is in. There are so many things which are being brought together in the classroom and it is given to the teachers. Now, respected teachers, principals, and academic, administrators around the world who are listening to me. I will say everything is under the same umbrella, nothing special. Everything is given in a different way catered to the students. I will say, if you are happy, you are giving everything positive, and the person who receives with happiness, and it is become a part of that individual, and it is permanent. Now, that is the importance of happiness curriculum. So I will say, let us learn how to be happy. Become happier. I'm starting with two scenarios because we all are educators from education institutions only. Now, first scenario.
Dr. Benny sir, we are not able to
teachers.
Hear you. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. There was a pause in the middle. We couldn't hear you. Yes. Now we can hear. Sorry.
I don't know. It is something interruption between, not from my side. Okay. From where did you hear? Where did I stop? Okay. We'll start with the scenario once again.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, there is two scenarios. First scenario is we are going to imagine a school, gate is wide open, the principal standing with a smile. The teachers, administrators, students, all are passing by. Everyone greet each other and principal is saying good morning to everybody and given a warm welcome. Now, when just imagine days pass, we will see some teachers touches the feet of the principal, some students touches the feet, the principal blesses, everything happy, and the day is happy. Teachers go happily to the classroom, staff room, then to the classroom, to the students to the ground, to the classroom, et cetera, et cetera. The day is happy. Now, let us take another scenario. Again, we have seen a school, the principal standing. To some, he says good morning, or she says good morning. Some says good morning, but she is or he is not out of prayer. He's not in the presence, looks somewhere else. Maybe looks gloomy. But maybe something going on in the mind of the principals. But we don't know. But as an individual, I am coming to the gate, I am greeting, good morning, sir, or good morning, ma'am. Automatically, I am not getting that warm. I think, what happened to me? Did I do something wrong? So this can happen and spoil, enter my day, the day of the teacher, the day of the students. So first of all, I will request all the principals, teachers, administrators here. Let us start a day with happiness. This happiness is the best momentous thing that you can do for yourself or the future of everybody, because it is something important which we have to nurture. Because happiness spreads through social network like a virus. Now we are in the time of pandemic. Now we know what is ORS. There is nothing to explain. I will say exactly the same way happiness spreads. Now, if we are happy and if we work on happiness, I will start with some positive strike. Scientifically, it is proved that you will feel better, you will be energetic, you will be creative, your immune system increases, you develop better rapport or relationships, then you become more productive, then you work more quickly than other time, and so on. There are different. Now, we are coming to the theme. What happiness, what determines happiness? The factors contributed to lasting happiness is circumstances, set point, intentional activity. We are putting to three categories. What does this mean? Because we have to see circumstances, set point, and intentional one by one. We are going to see. The life circumstances determine 10% of our matter. Usually we say, oh, it is because of that circumstances I could not do that. I will say in 100%, if you take in the 100%, it is only 10%. So we cannot much blame. Now come to set point. Set point comes to 50%. What is my color? How I look like, etc., etc. The temperament, the mood, the emotion, etc. Everything may come in set point. This also we cannot much manipulate. But we have the third one, intentional activity. It is the balance of 40%, which we are going to manipulate to develop a beautiful environment within us and the environment which is given to us, that is our classroom. So I will say we are owner of this 40%. Other things are one of set point, other one is circumstances, which we don't have much control over. But on this 40%, which we are going to manipulate and we are going to bring tremendous result in the world. Now, what are the happiness activities which we can follow? Express gratitude. Think optimistically. Avoid social comparison, practice acts of kindness, nurture relationships, develop strategies, learn to forgive, do activities that truly engage you, pay attention to the beauty around us, set some goals to achieve something important to you, practice your religion and immerse yourself in its rituals and compassion. And if you are not practicing religion, please be where you are, read more and have proper argumentations for that. Now, we are coming back to the happiness activities. Express gratitude. Does we lose anything if we say thank you for anything we receive, whether it is a big, small, etc. So let us start a day with gratitude for the day. Now, in this pandemic, we have to think, yes, we are alive today. Yes, I have opened my eye. Thank God for a new day. From there, we are going to acts of kindness. Then nurture relationships. Now, previous time we were always saying we don't have much family time. At present, we have full of family time because we are at home with our family members, close ones. So now let us develop. Now these are only activities which you all know. Now, I'm just getting you to the challenges which we allow to implement. So before I am putting a lack of time for planning. Nowadays, we can see that teachers are with full of activities, no time at all. Because at the end of the day, teachers become what to do. Everything is done. Anyway, there is a lack of time for the teachers. Lot of paperwork. Nowadays, teachers are having paperwork on paperwork, and everything is documented. It's not. So automatically, they are really tired. Then performance pressure from school administrators. For example, the principal says something, you are reaching the staff room. Now you see that you have a class, you are running to the class. Meanwhile, you are getting a call whether work is finished just after the class. So the teacher thinking, I was instructed for something. I went to the classroom. Now I am questioned. Did you do that? The pressure the teacher is going to experience. Then balancing diverse learning needs. There are different types of students sitting in front of us with different challenges. Then approaching burnout, tired, not even time to drink water, coffee, even the breakfast which is bought, snacks which is bought at school. They don't have time to eat because not time. Then lack of parental support. After doing everything, not getting adequate support from the parents, always blame, this is not done to my child, this is not done, this is lacking, this is self-time. Or mother, maybe a daughter, sister, brother, cousin, so many things. And India is among the world's least happy nations and ranked 122 among 155 countries in the global ranking. And in 2018, it has come to 133. It has slipped down. Now the condition, we don't know because studies are still going on. So we are the least country, and now we are on this contest, we are bringing the happiness curriculum. Now, whatever I am going to discuss from here is the happiness curriculum. I am not a teacher. I am a psychologist who is behind you teachers to help you to be happy in the classroom, in whatever you teach. So whatever I am going to discuss from here is referred from different parts, different things. And as a psychologist, it may be of my personal viewpoint too. But I will say, whatever you practice, let it be according to the institutional policy of you, the circulars received by you and everything. But you can take my word as an assistant to activate these programs in your classroom. Now, it is a scientifically designed curriculum. Now, this curriculum programs was started by the Deputy Chief Minister Manish Sisodia from Delhi. They have started these programs. Now, he says, or according to the team, it is a scientifically designed. What they say, if you practice exactly in your classrooms, in whatever you do, teach, then it is going to be permanent because you are teaching with a lot of activities and which is pertaining to happy curriculum. It goes together with inculcating art curriculum too. Help children to keep their mind focused on work. When you do happy curriculum activities, it increases the attention span of the child. The child gets focused because you are not going to say some theories, but you are literally actively participating, actively allowing children to participate. So without a participation, the classroom doesn't work out. So when we want to participate, we are literally focused. Then help them live harmoniously with family and society. Nowadays, this harmony with family, society is diminishing. We are becoming self-centric, selfish. So this happiness curriculum helps to collaborate, be harmony with the family members, society. So the teachers have to inculcate this in the classroom. Activities done together, etc. Now we'll develop holistic outlook and purpose in life. Now, whatever you do, whatever is said, is done from all the perspective, from different angle. And whatever you teach, the child should feed the purpose in life. I just want to go into our previous years when we were students. Just let us take from first standard to first grade to 10th grade. We studied so many things. So many teachers taught us many things and we got a lot of mark. How many of us remember exactly what has been taught to us? What all things are we practicing? Only things which is meaning to me or purposeful in my life, I remember. Others have faded away. Please always remember, my dear teachers. Let us teach. Make them feel what is the purpose of this learning. Then educate children to ensure harmony with their inner being and discover self in the process of learning. Make the education system an enabler for the all-round development of human mind. Let us change from selfishness to the human mind. All humankind has to get involved. If I want to be happy, all my brothers, sisters, or my colleagues who are sitting in my staff room, or in my students, all the students who are in the classroom should be happy. To inculcate happiness in children right from childhood. That is what now we teachers are going to. We are going to teach them how to be happy with what we are having. Create honest and responsible human beings. Then this curriculum will develop, will help to address the long-term societal issues and issues of mental health and well-being among students. So these are the curriculum area which we are going to. Now we are going to the main theory, how the happiness curriculum or why the happiness curriculum. And it is explained in a simplified way, happiness triad. This happiness is coming from through senses, then harmony in feelings, and learning and awareness. It is three dimensional of our aspect. Now we will explain one by one. Before that, we'll say, what does the happiness explain? As children grow up, their cognitive, psychomotor, and affective abilities develop. Here, if you think cognitive is related to intellectual process, psychomotor, physiological process, and affective, it is the warmthness of the child. They develop a strong desire in them to seek knowledge, to understand the world, and find meaning and purpose in life. Then being happy becomes a way of life for a child as they grow. Now we are going to see one by one the triad. We are going to take momentary happiness. Yes, anything and everything comes from the world is through our sense organs. The touch, the vision, the look I have, the smell, the taste, the sound. Through everything, it comes to me. Simple example. Today morning, my son came and gave me a kiss saying, "All the best, Papa." I received a lot of warmthness. I felt happy. Now, when we are coming to the classroom, all the students are together saying, "Good morning, teacher." Just imagine when entire students are saying together, folding their hand, "Good morning, teacher." Naturally, the goodness of this teacher will pour to the children in the form of blessing. Then the day is fresh. The teacher gives everything to the child. So, but we say these are to extend through the senses. It's a little momentary. Then we are coming. Okay. Now, happiness that you get through eating food, watching a film, listening to a music. These are maybe the momentary happiness. These are received through our senses. Now, little more higher. It is coming from feeling in relationship. The affection between husband and the wife, father, mother, the children, the friends, the colleagues, everything gives us a little more warmthness, feeling. For example, now Gayatri ma'am was saying good about me. I felt good, great, because many of you don't know me, so she gave a glimpse about me to you. So automatically I feel good. It is some sort of relationship bond. Then everyone expects these feelings to be fulfilled. You and me, everyone like this warmthness, the relationships, the positive outcome from the relationship with everyone. Then, when these expectations are met, we feel happy. Happiness from such feelings stay with us for a longer time than that is received through the senses. Now, the last one is sustainable happiness. That is what exactly you are going to do in learning and becoming the students aware in the classroom. Being aware of our thoughts, being mindful of our actions, and being free from internal conflict. This happiness is what we experience when we solve a problem, learn something new, understand a concept or some meaning that stays with us much longer period. Then a person who gets happiness from learning and awareness is able to sustain their happiness longer, is balanced person, then can retain sense of calm and peace. Respected teachers who are listening to me, please, these three are the happiness methodologies which you have to impart in your class. With that, we are coming to the objectives of happiness curriculum. to develop self awareness and mindfulness. So now we are in the classroom. We are going to teach any class. Let us make the child aware and mindful of what we teach. Help them to inculcate skill of critical thinking and inquiry. I request, I request the team to unmute the audience so that they can answer me.
Sure, sir.
Any teacher, what this child is doing, trying to do?
Solving puzzles.
What?
Solving puzzles.
Yes.
Kind of puzzle.
No, can you just elaborate what he is exactly thinking? Let us think from the child's point of view.
Will these two puzzle pieces fit each other? Will they fit together?
Now he is thinking, if I put this edge to this hole, whether it suits. Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, very good afternoon. Very good afternoon. I'm here.
Now, anybody who can give a sentence and I expect an answer from other person?
Yes.
Now, what is, does this speak, picture speak?
Say every time hi and smiling.
Okay. Now, you are giving a hi or smiling. Please, somebody else respond for that.
Our thoughts keep expanding. It starts from a small thing and it goes on to become bigger and bigger. So
ma'am,
what we put into
other teacher has told you a hi and smile. You respond to that.
Okay, I was responding to the photograph here.
Okay, now please respond to the ma'am's statement. I'll say hi to you.
I have to say hi. Okay.
Yes. Here, the warmthness is being developed. That is, I want to say. Now, in our classroom, what we are going to make the children think is, what is happening? Now I question you, I put inquiry. In your classroom, when you are developing it, you will get all sort of questions, all sort of blockage, everything, but you are inculcating. Now, enable learners to communicate effectively and express themselves freely and creatively. Now I am going to show something else. Anybody who can say what is this? What do you think? This art?
A dancing girl.
Somebody say it's a dancing. Somebody else? Something, any other point?
Dr. Benny sir, one second. Those who are not answering, please mute yourself. It looks really, you know, not nice when you people speak at all.
I think you can mute everybody.
Can I? Okay, thank you.
Disturbance is coming in.
Yes. Yeah.
Mute, ma'am.
I have done, sir. I think you may have to unmute yourself. Benny, sir, you need to unmute yourself.
Thank you, ma'am. Can you hear me? Yes.
Yes,
now,
sir.
In this picture, it is the creative. Anything you can think about, whatever you say is correct. A girl is dancing or some other thing dimension, you have the right to think from different angle, and this is your perspective. You are not wrong. We have 40, 30, 50, 60 students. They have the right. I will say, in our teaching curriculum, when we are happy, we cannot tell a student, you are wrong. But instead that, you can ask them, please explain, how did you get that? And if you want to modify, you can ask, look from this perspective, you will get a better, different result. Don't say you are wrong, you are right, etc., etc. You always encourage for a difference. So then let them think differently. Now another chart. This is simply a line. To a Christmas season, sometimes we may say it's a Christmas tree or anything we will say. Whatever be, we have the right. The child has the right to interpret. So same way, whatever you teach in the class, the child has the permission to express freely what they think. Because if you block, the communication become harm. The child think, am I right, wrong? Don't create those things. Let the child learn to express themselves. Now, enable learners to understand their expectation in relationships, develop empathy, and ensure healthy relationship with family, peers, teachers, etc. Now, we have few future. See, we can interpret anything. A happy family is going for an outing. Or maybe they're going for a purchase. Or maybe they're having an outing in the health. Whatever the child want to explain, let them explain. Some children will say, it is not my father or mother. Or some say, it is my elder brother and sister. Or it is my grandfather and grandmother. They have the freedom. Let us give them freedom to interpret what they want. But let us give them the idea. And let us tune them properly to what subject we are teaching. Now here, again, another picture. The child has all the right, we all have all the right to interpret the way we want. Now, why I am saying these things? We have the right. Now we are enabling the students to understand their expectation relationship, develop empathy, etc. So let us give them correct living example in the classroom to develop these sort of things so that they become happy. Now, enable learners to apply life skill to deal with stressful, conflicting situations. Now, for example, life skill, we can bring anything. How a child is getting ready, how he play, how he sleep, how he eats, etc. Whatever life skill you teach, but you are teaching and it should become long lasting so that a situation arises for the child, it become easy for the child to solve that challenge. So our objective, what is the objective? The child learns to manage the situation or conflicting situation and deal effectively with the stressor just in front of him. Then to develop social awareness, human values in learners to engage in meaningful contribution to the society. Now, always say to the children, whatever you learn, you give to others, you will be happy. It is a sharing. Now, I am a teacher. I am teaching you. What is being given to me by my teachers, my friends, and whatever I have learned in my development, I am giving to you. And same way, you have to give to your people around you. Now, develop holistic approach to education in a universal context. Now, we are going to see the code of ethics or teaching regulations. It is only to you all know about it. I'm just bringing to the awareness about the code of ethics from three angles. One is teachers' responsibilities to the people or the students, he or she care. So total development of the child is the responsibility of the teacher. Whatever you subject you teach, the child should impart from it something good. Child should involve himself or herself. Now, we teachers say, oh, the classroom is very difficult. They don't cooperate. There are different types of individuals. Some understand, some doesn't understand, some are very hyper. I will say, do we blame others or are we getting blamed? why these children are different? They are different by itself. But I am teaching something, when I bring happy curriculum, automatically they all get involved in this curriculum, in the activity of learning. Then being a teacher, I become strong. Now, other one is teacher's responsibility to colleagues and the teaching profession. It is two dimension. It is profession one side and the colleagues. Am I? Now we have to examine, do I have a passion towards teaching, or by effect for the salary, I don't get any job, I have come to the teaching profession? Think. So I have certain responsibilities which I have to do. I have to respect, I have to teach, I have to be punctual, and always I have to be modern. A teacher has no rest. In the school, outside the school, even the supermarket, you are a teacher to a student. Even after retirement, I'm taking this one. My teacher also is listening to this talk. With all respect, I say, what he has taught me is with me. So I will say, lifelong, he is a teacher to me. And whatever he does, I look from the perspective of a student-child relationship, student-teacher relationship. So every profession, we have retirement. Teacher has no retirement. Lifelong teacher is a teacher. So the responsibility of a teacher is very big. Then teacher's responsibility to the parents and the community. You are molding the community, no other profession. A child of 2 years, 3 years is given to you. Now you are molding them after 18, then 21, 25, 28. You are giving a product to the world. Yes, we have created an engineer, a doctor, a good professor, a mechanic, whatever be. Now, this is the responsibility of the teacher. And it is not one teacher. It's a chain of teacher. Years and years. I pass one child to another teacher and it is going on. It's accumulative. Like we say, we have to make anecdotal record. We are creating the generation. And finally, a child is coming out. But some teachers will be unhappy because we teach the child and the 12th standard rank come for something and the teachers of 12th standards are appreciated. We feel fat because we gave the foundation in the KG. We gave the foundation in the primary. We are never acknowledged. Sorry, teachers, you are greatly acknowledged by the student and the family members, even the teachers themselves. Only thing is, their immediate preparation was by those teachers, so they are rewarded. Don't feel bad. I don't know how to distribute this reward. I don't know. Again, I give to the principals this duty. Because it is a duty of the principals to reward positively. And because the responsibility on the teachers are great. Now, we are coming to the learning style. To teach properly, we should know the learning style of the children. We learn through auditory, visual, kinesthetic. These are the three areas the learning happens. For example, if you take a child, one of three will be dominant and others are partially giving. So we are coming to the auditory learning. Tips for auditory learners. For the, it is a, what is a eye-opening for the teachers, they should know. They give more effective for spoken word. So they learn from the mouth of the teacher. For example, if you take my son, for him, whatever happens, the teacher is the fool. If teacher teach him properly, he knows exactly what he's been taught. He is more to auditory learn. For him, the teacher is highly important. So always for his higher education, I select a school or college where the teaching skills are very high, because he is an auditory learner. Now, tips for visual learners. 90% or maybe more than 60% of our students are visual learners. And we inculcate the happy curriculum for these visual learners more, so that the auditory learning, visual learning, kinesthetic learning, everything put together. Now, for the visual learners, the written information, notes, diagrams, videos, every activity you do, everything is important, like the kinesthetic. Because for the kinesthetic learners, everything should be done. Whatever is done, they never forget. So whatever they want to learn, they will. You may be seeing some students scribbling on newspaper, whatever they learn, they write. Some students walk and learn. If they sit on a place and learn, they will not be able to learn properly. So these are the three styles of learning. And remember, my dear teachers, in your classroom, every student is with these three styles of learning. And everybody is having three, and people have diverse thought process. So inculcate these three type of thought process into you. Now, a teacher should move from one to one place to one another place. Have different gestures, different activities, so that everybody learns well. With this, we are coming to the syllabus outcome, outline. The curriculum is designed on the basis of happy triad. Already we have discussed the triad. Happiness life is there, affection is there, intellectual growth is there. Now, through engagement in meaningful and reflective stories and activities, we can create these things. Then regular happiness classes will enable students to reflect on the relationship between their feelings, thoughts, behavior, and their impact on themselves, family, society around them, and the natural environment. Then other outline is, a syllabus is universal and designed age appropriately. Like any other subject, students will have a happiness period every day. Teacher's handbook for happiness class include a description of meaningful activities, stories, etc. Now, I think teachers already have received the handbooks. It is available from KG to 8th standard. You can have your curriculum books so that you will get lot of activities, lot of things than the happiness you give in your common classroom. I will not say happiness curriculum should be an exclusive period. It should be imparted in every period. And we put some activities in the certain classes, assigned by the school, so that it is directly used for only for that period, so that the activities are formulated and you get more time for that. But always be careful. Don't use this period for other substitution subject or completion of syllabus, etc. Please always think happiness is important. So we impart some knowledge, some activity to the student so that they become more and more happy. Now syllabus outline is from three angles: exploring happiness through learning and awareness. So the classroom is for exploring happiness through learning and awareness. So knowing my needs, harmony in self, happiness my goal, then the education, why I do the education. So everything is coming to. For example, a max teacher is teaching in the class. Why do I learn this? The students should have the answer for that. In my life, what I am going to do with this happiness, or what this activity, what I am learning, everything should have a knowledge. Then experiencing happiness in relationships through feelings. How similar are we? From here, we are thinking a child is coming from egocentric to a feeling everybody. They should think of everybody together. Then harmony in relationship, understanding values in relationship, then cooperation and collaborative living. They should learn. So this should be one of the outline for the teachers to have the happiness curriculum. Let the children do together. There is no senior, junior, rich, poor, color discrimination, anything. No, everyone is together. Then harmony relationship, everything is we made in this one. Then syllabus outline is happiness through active participation. Living in an interconnected society. If I am alone, I am not happy. In the beginning, some students say, I don't need that person, this friend, that friend. No. Child should understand the importance of living together, interconnected. For example, in this time of pandemic, we have understood how the EQ work out. And SQ is giving more important, social quotient. How we important is our connections. When we were in our house, having no connection with the outer world, how bad we were feeling, how lonely we were feeling. When we did not go for a outing, we did not go a film, we did not go for shopping, how bad we were feeling. So automatically, it is a correct time to teach what is the need of interconnection between people. So it leads to coexisting with the nature. The importance of living in the nature, giving to the nature, receiving from the nature, etc. Now, the design and pedagogy. We are going to come to see again serious matter. It is coming from National Curriculum Framework, NCF 2005. Was written to set the tone of education in India. It had set guiding principles for all the subject matter to achieve the goal of education. Happiness curriculum has been designed to fulfill the lacuna in the current education by aligning with the guiding principle of NCF 2005. What is this happiness curriculum according to the NCF? Let us see. Now, design and pedagogy, what they are saying, if we do this way, this will be the output. So guiding principle is connecting knowledge to life outside the school. So whatever we teach, we should have a connection for the child to live outside. All the content in the happiness curriculum is based on real life examples. Then only the child will be free to connect with the people. Then ensure that learning is shifted away from rote method. When I was a child, my teachers gave important to learn this, learn this, learn this. This is important, this is not important. So I mug up everything. What is being told? So now we are going away from this rote learning method. Now enriching the curriculum to provide all overall development of children rather than textbook centric. Now, textbook is a guiding principle for the child or the teacher, not exactly what is the guide. So let us use the guide and let the teacher give the matter to the student. So these are the area, then nurturing and overriding identity informed by caring concern within the democratic policy of the country, etc., is the NCF policies. Now, the approach. Following methodologies would be the approach we can bring in our particular extra classes. So this much time we were seeing what we can do to give. I will say, than this extra class, according to the CBSE or other school norms, in every teacher, in every subject should incorporate the happiness curriculum. Plus, we will have few periods assigned for happy curriculum according to the institutional policies. In that, what all things we can incorporate. Following methodologies would be used to explore, experience, and express happiness. Joyful exercises. Let us give exercises. It can be ground, it can be at the classroom, or it can be any place wherever you like. But it should be for joyful experiences. When it is joyful, when the child is creative, without much do's and don'ts, but under discipline. For that, I will say the teachers should introduce the policy. Okay, today we are going to do this. These are the outcome we want to do from this. So these are the behavior expected from you. These things you can do, this you cannot do. Everything can be told to the child in a nutshell. So that the exercise becomes joyful and you will have a disciplined community around you. Indoor games. There are different games available indoor. You plan anything. What is suiting to the age of your classroom, and availability of the material in your school. Everything has to be planned. Even you can bring certain things. For indoor games, we can cut so many papers. Okay, ask them to join together, make it one picture. Or something, okay, musical chair, etc., etc. There are so many games available, please. Then active inquiry. Now you are putting something. You are welcoming the questions. Please allow others to answer to that query. Let them say whatever they like. Don't tell them you are wrong, right? Because you are helping through this to express themselves, both verbal expression and behavioral expression. Even from the childhood, if you are saying do's and don'ts much in during the time of expression than the guidelines, the child learns down to express himself or herself. That is a 90% of we all are having. We always think, whether am I right, wrong, what others will, everything. We are thinking, what sort of judgment others are going to make around me? Please, we are limiting our children. Now, reflective conversations. I'm giving a thought. Okay. Today, when I came out of my home, I saw two persons for walking. Okay, now please continue. You reflect on who are these two people, what are things they will do, etc. You are giving out time. Now some will say brother and sister were going, boyfriend and girlfriend was going, father and mother was going. Okay, younger sister was carried by elder brother to the school. So many can be given the reflections. Let anything freely flow. But lead the conversation so that they express, ask queries, again, inquiries. Okay, where did they go? What did they do? What was the dressing pattern? What culture they were from? Now, these things give a imaginative idea in the child and the child learns better. Then storytelling. This is usually a pattern which we follow in our classrooms. But I will say, in the happiness curriculum, when we have happiness period, storytelling should not become 1% and others are listeners. Storytelling can be a group activity and other things. It should be a group activity. Involvement of majority of the students should come together. It should be together. It should not be one way. then guided practices of mindfulness. Let us teach them how to be mindful. You can bring maybe meditation aspects or other awareness aspects, whatever you feel. Always it is good. Now, group discussions. Again, a thought is given, others are discussing. There is no right and wrong. Only thing is, the classroom should be balanced and it should be under control. You can divide as you like. For this, teacher has to plan early. What is going to be, what is going to be the outcome, etc. Teacher should have it in, and teacher is leading the discussion. Then role play, skit, on situation, etc. Other one can be presentations, individual or group presentation. But again, I will say, when you take individuals, always see that the group is active with the individual. It should not become into a, what do you say, monotonous program. Some people will put a video for the approach. I will say it is not correct. Video can be put for some time and discussion can be generated on the video. Then it becomes group activity. Otherwise, only the video is running, all are visual. We are seeing a picture, nothing else. So please, this period is meant for activity based. There should be a lot of things together done as a group, because we want to bring the unity among the students, integration, warmthness, etc. Then activities for rapport building and teamwork. So everything should have this objective. For this approach, any teacher who is taking this period should be closely associated with this classroom. I will say, if we are assigning a period or a two period, a three period, let the class teacher be the in charge of this period. Because the class teacher knows in and out of each and every individual with his strength and limitations. So I will always request, always a teacher who is able to know everybody, can give completely, let them do this happiness hour when we are assigning as a period. Now the learning outcome of this happiness period becomes mindful and attentive. Everything we have discussed. So when I am giving this period, my children become mindful and attentive. That means my class become more alert, cooperative, and the output is very higher. Students learn. Students take things to their life. And the learning become permanent. Now, develops critical thinking and reflection. The outcome of this happy curriculum is they think differently, critically, intellectually, with rationalization. Yes, he did this. Why did he do this? What can be the background? On what direction he has put this point? Everything coming to matter. Then develop social and emotional skills. We learn to relate with others. Show, demonstrate empathy. We will be able to, manage our stress and other challenges in life, etc. Then develops confident and pleasant personality. I become more confident and I'm happy to be everywhere. Because from my childhood, I am not blocked my expression by my teachers. They have guided me how to present myself happily. They have guided me where to put a full stop, what to say, what not to say. Everything is guided. These are the four learning outcomes. my dear teachers, when you are bringing any form of teaching, this should be the outcome. Mindful, and the child should be attentive to the matter. Develop critical thinking and reflection, social and emotional skills. Then let that person become confident and have a pleasant personality. Now, we are coming to the last areas, how this happiness period is going to be evaluated. Please, dear teachers, there is no written examination for this happiness period. The teachers will assess the students in a qualitative way and will convert their assessment into quantifying outcomes. Progress will be continuously evaluated by the teacher, and its record may be maintained weekly by teachers in their diaries. Then happiness curriculum focused on the process rather than the outcome. Be careful. Happiness curriculum is focusing on the process than the outcome. We cannot predict an outcome and activity. How they involve, how they think, how they integrate, these things are more important than the result of the activity. It can be right, it can be wrong, we did not reach in anywhere, whatever happens is not a problem at all. Then this assessment should be done with humility and integrity. Let us wholeheartedly do it. Now, training design. This is for the schools or the principals or the coordinators. First of all, orientation of concerned teachers. Now, the teachers who are going to deal with the happiness curriculum, they should be properly oriented. How? What? Now we are having a small orientation program. Now we know almost what all things we have to do to this matter. So in your school, who are going to deal with this happiness hours especially? They should be oriented properly. So automatically what I will say, they should participate like these programs. Know more about this happiness curriculum. Read about happiness curriculum. Get involved in different types of activity so that they can impart to their children. Then identify happiness coordinators. I will say each session or primary, pre-primary, primary, middle, senior, secondary, everybody should have a coordinator. If a school is very big, then each division, each standard may have a coordinator. So that all the second standard students are having the similar thing. Let the parents may not make any comparison between the teacher's activities. Everything, let it be coordinated. So there should be a coordinator who coordinates the activities. I will say the coordinator also should know what are the indoor activity, outdoor activity, everything. All teachers should not go to the park, to the ground, to the pool together. No, it should be designed such a way that everybody is having different activities in the same time so that we utilize our proper time. For example, a teacher is taking to the ground or exploring the vegetable garden. If two, three teachers are taking their students, automatically the garden becomes, we have a very small school or big school. What, how much is the garden? We don't know. According to the facilities, let us coordinate. So these are the duties of the coordinator to maintain. They should know what is going to happen, what is not going to happen. And they have to structure happiness period such a way that it is extended to all the classes in a different time so that it's not having much disturbances, much problems in the setup. Then training of happiness coordinators as facilitators. See, now this is a training session. How to imbibe? Attend more training classes. And I will request the school or management to conduct more training sessions and activity sections. Also, different sessions on different contents, especially whatever comes from psychological perspective, social perspective, other area, academic perspective, you know. Why? Because we should know, accept the individual differences, everything. So automatically, I will say a lot of psychological related matters should be known well to the teacher so that they can think, okay, this is because of this. They should get some sort of rationale. Then the reading will help them. Then large scale, intensive, recurring training, which we already discussed. There should be large scale. These are the training design which is given to the schools. So this repeated, so that new activities incorporated, how the, art learning, happiness, everything can be put together, everything can come into picture. Now, open to the ground, whatever you want to ask me, you can ask.
I request the intern team to kindly take up the questions, put in the chat box. And request the participants to share your queries or your doubts in the chat box, please. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. It was an amazing session. And I would also like to thank all participants who have shared their feedback and their thoughts while the session was being conducted. So we have a couple of doubts for you, Benny, sir. When you were explaining about the tips for kinesthetic and visual learners, one of the participants had asked, how to know the learning styles of a child?
Okay. Now, learning style of the child, teacher can know from the activities the provided by the teacher. Now, when we have the art learning happiness curriculum, it is more easy for the teacher to know. How does the child capture? For example, auditory learning. If ma'am can put my screen, me to it, automatically auditory learn always lean forward, put this. A lot of gestures will be shown by the auditory learner. And visual learners will be moving. Whatever you do, whatever activity, they will be looking at different places. And kinesthetic learners, always, it is very difficult to understand from our classroom environment. We can learn from the total school setup. For example, some students are all-rounders. For example, now we just take the example of student council. They will have different activities and they top the school. How did they top? So they coordinated with the kinesthetic together with 90% of leaders, and the so-called leaders in the school will be kinesthetic together with kinesthetic learners. But again, to correctly to understand, we have to examine the child. In which activity, what sort of activity, the grasping level is increasing. So it has to be thoroughly evaluated by the teacher, maybe one or two periods, 1 or 2 months with different activities of your subjects. For example, now I am teaching a subject. One topic is being taught. If I closely evaluate our student, what is being liked by 90%, 70%, what is not liked, which pattern of my teaching is being taught, you will get this type of learners from that. Because closely evaluation of my teaching method is very important to evaluate this learning style of my words. But it is always, we will not say, this is the learning style. I will say in three, one will be dominant, other two are supporting. Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much, sir.
Okay.
The next question up for you is regarding the methodologies used to explore and express happiness. One of the participants asked, how do we get the curriculum guide?
I think curriculum guide is available because already I have from KG to 8th standard. I think it is will be available from the sites or from the school. I don't know what is being acquired by your school. I don't know. If you want things from me, I have no objection in sharing what I have. I have in PDF format. All the books are available, and it is given to me by my friend or one of the principal. And from I have all the textbook from pre-primary to 8th standard, happy curriculum. It is made as a book. It is available.
That will be really if wonderful.
If you are interested, you then share. Even I can hand over to Gayatri ma'am. Gayatri ma'am can to send to every participant. Because sure, it is a universal thing. It is not anybody's property.
But still, thank you Gayatri so much ma'am, for sharing that.
Yeah. So I will say, I will give it to Gayatri ma'am. The, all, let us share with all the participants. There is nothing wrong. Am I right? Because what is our objective is so that the teachers may correctly practice and our children profit. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Definitely. It will be a great help for all the teachers. Thank you so much, sir. A small request from Sitanshu, sir, if you could give a message, especially for the parents of our children, as they're sometimes most disappointed persons, just to feel, make them feel they're capable.
I don't think our parents are sitting in this forum. No, only teachers. Sitanshu, sir, Gayatri, ma'am, am I right?
Yes, Sitanshu, sir, is our one of our team builder. He's a founder of Mission Capability.
Okay, ma'am, what should I do? Is there parents
he would like, he's here only. He wants a message for particularly for send children.
Okay. See, I am unique. You are unique. I am precious. You are precious. Say, everyone in the world is precious. My son is precious to me. My sister is precious to me. My friend is precious to me. This is what each and everyone should have in our mind. Strength and limitations are there. I have my limitations together with my strength. When you love me with your objective to accept me with my strength and limitations, I become close to you. Now coming to the classroom, we have different students with different capabilities. And some are so-called inclusive children or SEND children or what do you say, some sort of disability children or exceptional children, etc. Whatever term you give, you give. I will say everyone is having strength together with limitations. So it varies. I will say to the parents, in my life of 11 years plus, very close to schools, before that I have worked as a psychologist to school, but I have become a counselor to school only in Indian School Muscat. And I don't know, parents come to me for their simple matters, how the future of the child can be achieved, especially for the inclusion. Simple word is, I will say, future is there if you catch the child and walk for years till where the child becomes independent. You have no other way. Because the eldermost son of me, who is from Indian School Muscat, it's not mint, my mint, the child I have taken, he is studying in Trichy, third year engineering now. No, he has gone to fourth year engineering now. He is with, autism, Asperger. Since he is academically brilliant, he got admission, and I will say happily, government has given staff quarters for the parents also to be with the child. It is because the mother or the father was with the counselor, with the special educators, with the teachers, taking the child. By 7th standard, 8th standard, this child become independent. The buddy was created. The child was together with the buddy. But sometime we will know some sort of exceptions because he cannot read between lines. Certain, what do you say, understood, undermined things will not be grasped by. For them, they are straightforward. If teacher is teaching something, the child will get up, please explain. Teacher explain. I did not understand, please explain. Teacher will ask. But I will say, if the teacher is being trained properly, teacher knows how this strength and limitation of this child, to my experience, I will say hearts of Indian school Muscat and Indian schools in Oman. We have included whoever comes to our school's gate with any challenges. We don't have discriminations. And we accept everybody. We make them seated. If you look into the teacher classrooms, we can see many mothers sitting together with the children. That is the experience. So here, there are problems. Problems is the adult seeing an adult. Teacher is an adult, seeing there is another adult sitting in the classroom. Teacher feels bad. For that, first is training the teachers. The making the heart of the teacher very big to accommodate everyone in the classroom. Teaching style differences. And everything and anything is given to the teacher in a paper format. It is given, this child is having this disability, these are the strengths, limitation, these are the exceptions available. Everything is given to the teacher. And parents also are instructed. The shadow mother also is understood what is the duties and responsibility of the shadow mother. So shadow mother cannot interfere with the teacher. Teacher never get afraid of this shadow mother that anything of my limitation will go out. Nothing. So what I want to tell the parents, be with your son and daughter. They are precious to me and to you. If we can bring changes, whole world can make changes. I will say I have been discussed with many area, many people, even many universities have called me to have discussion on this. I will say it is possible provided the parents and the teachers cooperate. Because I remember in one of the schools in Oman, when the teachers entered the classroom, mother was sitting, immediately teacher went out, told the principal, no more I am going to teach in the class. Immediately call came to me, Dr. Bedi, what to be done? I told, I am going to meet the teacher in front of you. I just told the teacher with the permission of the principal and taking to the CBSE norms and regulations, if you are not ready to teach, another teacher will go, but the parents will remain for the child. Because CBSE says they have the room to learn. If one teacher is not there, we will get another teacher to teach. I'm not disrespecting the teacher. I was burdening. Now she is one of the best teacher for me in Oman who takes care of any challenges in the classroom. She was afraid because another adult was sitting in the classroom. Even last year, I have advised a group of teachers who are going to the classroom of particular autism child, beware. The mother who is sitting with the shadow is an MTech lady. That means whatever you teach, you should be very cautious. But whoever teachers went to the classroom, they all came to me and told, we don't have any problem with the shadow mother. And the teacher asked the feedback, to me through the shadow mother. I asked this mother, what is your opinion about this subject? What this mother tell me, Dr. Benny, 12 years my son is studying in this school. In the beginning, when I became shadow mother, leaving my job, you have told me never evaluate the teacher and discuss anything about the teacher. Till now I follow. So, Dr. Benny, I have nothing to say. My son is learning from the teacher. I am happy with it. I felt very happy. Now they have moved to India. And students have reached different levels. And if I say in different schools, 21 schools in Oman, I'm very proud over the counselor or a psychologist. I will say, I became a part of this venture together with many counselors, many teachers. And I will say hearts up to teachers because you teachers made it. We only told what can be done. And I will say this happiness curriculum with incorporating many, many activities, many style of learning, you are going to bring this more forward. It is more going to become more easy for you. So I will tell my parents, don't be afraid. If you are persistent, you should be continuously working with the child according to the challenges faced by the child. I say disability, I am not saying, I am saying challenges. Challenge I can have, you can have, the child also can have. Let us take it as a challenge. So this challenge has limitations. Let us do proper analysis. Let us work out a strategy. And let us give to the teachers also prior info. Don't hide anything. Then let us work out and bring the future of this child. I'm happy to say, even I have been asked by authorities to bring in certain vocational skills for these children. What can be given to these children? What are jobs they can get into? Even the University of Calicut had a recent discussion with me. What sort of job? Now the government is saying this many percentage have to be incorporated. What? How can we give? When the department was discussing, first of all, let us have a mind to give. Let us understand them. And let us cannot have a common evaluation for them. We have to find out the length, strength and limitation of the child and give the duty. And we cannot manipulate the duty. They will not allow, like others. They are straightforward people. If they say 5x is missing, means 5x is missing, the 5 is incomplete. So please, corrections can work with us. They did not work with us, with them. So I will say my parents, future is there for everybody, provided we work with them. And this happiness curriculum is bringing in lot of things to the children. And the outcome is going to be a big thing. Why? Because see, whatever is taught in the class, we are learning only for examination point of view. Whatever is good, we are imbibing to my life. We are taking it. Otherwise, no. Others are left. It's fade away, not used. So don't think that everything should be learned and mark is the base. I will say, mark course is important. But whatever you taught is being understood to the child, received to the heart, is doing according to that. That is more important. Okay, next question, please.
Before that, so before Akshaya goes to the next question, Dr. Benisa, thank you so much that this question was beautifully answered. And special thanks from Sitanshu, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Before proceeding to the next question, I have a small request to the admin team. Many of them are asking, are you sharing the PPT recording, PDF and feedback form? If you could either respond now or via chat box to them.
Yes, we will be uploading the recording in the YouTube and which will be shared with the participants. Yes. PPT, it is Dr. Benny's own this one that he has to tell, but the recordings will be shared in the through YouTube.
Sharing of PPT, I have no objection. provided Gayatri ma'am has no objection. But I will say recordings will be more important for you, because what is discussed, PPT also you can see in the recording and you can see the explanation. PPT, everything is not written. So PPT doesn't make a sense for you. It's only record. Instead of that, I will say always go with the recordings so that you will get both the PPT slide and the recordings together. I think that will be better.
Very true, sir. Very true.
Yeah.
I must challenge into this. If you go with the government guidelines, there are certain government guidelines by government of Delhi and city. So you will find the exact how we need to implement this thing in the school. There is a 2014 guideline by government of Delhi. So if you go with that, you will get more insight into this for implementation.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for sharing. Proceeding to the next question, one of the participants has asked, how can they work for school happiness program as a psychologist?
See, psychologist working as a happiness program, I will say, you are the leader to give insight to the teachers. Let you work through the different sessions and teach the teachers how to do it. And if you are assigned a topic, teach the topic with the activities, nourishing the theme, what you want to impart. For example, you want to give some social skills or maybe a talk on empathy, then inculcate those thought process and everything inside. Simple example, I will say. Years before you, whether you know famous, presenter, M.S. Menon. He's a non-famous, presenter in India. One of his presenting, I had to travel with him to the place. That time I was psychologist running my institution back in Kaladi. Then he told, Dr. Benny, I need your help. Okay, I told X. Now the program well begun. Suddenly I collapsed. I showed epileptic symptoms and all the attention of the crowd came to me. Even one or two of my friends' specs were broken, dress were torn. So many things happened and it became very big havoc. Then slowly MS Menon told the crowd, now I'm happy that you all got into the importance of helping a people, man, who is having a problem. Now, for this theme, it is an artificially created environment. So Dr. Benny, please stand up. I got up, talk went on, but people could not believe that I don't have that problem. Even I remember after the talk, after the brain between break, many people came, are you all right now? How do you feel? I told, no, it is not having it. They told, you acted such a way that the theme was without any explanation came to us. I will say, this is the role of you psychologist, you mentors. You have to impart what you intend to the children. Theory doesn't make a sense. Happiness curriculum means it is doing by learning. And they are thinking different angle. Their critical mind is working. They become more attentive, etc., etc., etc. Whatever be. So I will say, the psychologist, create things for your school beautifully with activities which is practical for that age and the classroom. Thank you. Hello.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Next question is regarding the vocations. How do you work with adults when it comes to vocations?
Once again, the question, please. Repeat the question.
How to work with adults when it comes to vocations?
No. Before that, you made some statement.
This is with regarding to vocation.
Okay.
How to work with others when it comes to vocations?
Vocation means you are saying activities or a job?
May I request the participant to kindly elaborate the question, please? Because this is about the
please
happiness.
Ask the participant to unmute and have the elaboration.
Or can if you can raise the hand, we will unmute you. May I request the participant to kindly raise the hand or elaborate the question in the chat box.
Otherwise, regarding vocation, I will say, Gayatri ma'am, can you just give answer to this question?
Kavita, it is Kavita, I feel.
Yes, one second.
Please, madam, go ahead with your question.
Kavita ma'am, I have given you permission to unmute. You can ask now.
Can you hear us, Kavita ma'am?
Okay, now leave it. Since the question is asked, Gayatri ma'am, can you just put insight to it? Oh, Pradeep sir?
Yes.
See, there are two ways we need to address this. Firstly, as per the vocation, which we take it to take as the job. Secondly, the exercises which we are taking for a happiness curriculum. So it will be better if you guide us for both the things, how we can take it.
So actually vocations and when we say happiness curriculum, when how Dr. Benny sir was explaining about everything, it really vocations also helps us in improving the skills of a particular child. So depending again on the challenges or the needs or the skills they possess. So when we really start developing the skills, automatically the happiness or the self, the esteem, the satisfied sense of achievement really improves in the child, and the happiness automatically comes. For example, in the school where I was working, vocation was a part of a skill development. So we used to work on their challenges through the vocations. So, and this particularly when we say vocation, it changes from person to person, I mean child to child, what particular skill we need to impart. So when we did as a vocational club itself, so that really had a great impact on their self-esteem, their communication skills, in their expressive language. It worked on many skills, I should say. And automatically we could see the same, the output coming up with the academics also. So their academic growth really improved. So vocation has to be a part, particularly for children with special needs, I would say. So, but it depends from child to child. I hope I can
I want to just contribute something yes, to sir, the background
please.
Of this.
Please, sir.
I'm not prejudiced with anything, but I want to say when you are deciding a vocation, first of all, do a thorough IQ of this child. Now, when you are doing performance and verbal IQ, you will get 11 disparities or 12 disparities and see where the child is good. Whether the child is having whatever disability, please try to do DTRD. Why I'm saying DTRD? It is having 10 dimensions. Exactly, you will be knowing which are the area the child is having exact challenges. Then clubbing this everything and other knowledge, other activities, please lead the child to a vocation. Then the child will remain in the vocation, will do happily this vocation. Otherwise what we'll do, it will become trial and error. Please don't go for a much trial and error. Trial and error is good. But see, we have time from KG till 12th standard, 10th standard, trial and error. Then from there, we are cultivating, nurturing a program for this child. For that, we have to come to a conclusion. These are the strengths, these are the limitations. With this strength, which are being added, which can be added to it. Then add that, then keep the child the child become more happy, child will give, and it become a habit because routine doing, and he will be perfect in it. Only thing is, you cannot take into granted certain things. They will do exactly what is important. Anything, everything, you should have a monitoring or prior discussion with the child. Thank you.
True, doctor. I totally agree to that, because that test actually tells about the complete strength of a child and complete what about the needs of the child. So vocations need to be depend. That's what we say. It depends from child to child. And thank you, doctor, for your insight. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, ma'am. Adding to Dr. Benny's and Gayathri madam's actually oversight, all teachers and schools should go for need assessment for the children. If they follow the need assessment, they will be getting insights how happy the child is. And by that, they can come out with the strength and weakness, and then they can work on that.
True, sir. Perfect. Yes. Only then, our whatever we do, it comes out as a holistic.
Thank you so much. So we have one request from Meena, ma'am. If you could show the auditory screen.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. I hope Meena ma'am is able to take screenshot of it. Proceeding to the next question. The participant wants to know how to evaluate happiness with example.
Question is not clear to me.
I think they want to know how the happiness can be evaluated, and if you could explain with help of an example.
Happiness doesn't have a formal evaluation. How it is being cooperated by the child is being evaluated. How involvement they are doing, what are things they are getting to do. And finally, happiness means what? Are they happy? If they are happy, they get involved. Give importance for marking for this involvement and way of doing, etc. Please, outcome doesn't have any evaluation. Only the way it is being cultivated is important. Today, I may be sad. I may not understand exactly the teacher is doing. Then teacher should think, why the child could not involve? Is it anything disturbing the child? Or the child has not understood exactly what is meant? Everything should be evaluated. That means evaluation is done with the teacher. By the teacher. I will say there is no fixed criteria for evaluation. No. You think, is the group work is happening, the activities are well taken by the child, involvement of the child, etc. It is the duty of the teacher to get involved by the child. That means the activity, if the child is involved, that means it is not reaching to the child. If I am happy, I will be fully engaged. So automatically, the teacher has to plan activities such a way that children should get engaged into it. That is a first evaluation. Yes, I think I have answered.
So, Dr. Benny, I need to then actually ask, it means that there will not be a qualitative, there will be a qualitative but not the quantitative assessment, you can say.
Yeah, we have told in the evaluation same term. Qualitative evaluation, not quantitative.
Yeah.
Thank you
so
much, sir.
I have
sir.
Just put the evaluation criteria. I have put no written examination. The teacher will be assessing the students on qualitative way and converted to quantifying method. Yes.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Proceeding to the next question, many schools refuse to admit SEND children, though there is inclusive education policy. Then how do you help them?
See, helping will not work out. It is the policy which caters the need. Now, CBSC has made mandatory, if it is not getting to practice by 2020, that means this academic year or the next academic year onwards, even the license can be cancelled. Clearly, it is stated by years. They are putting repeated circulars. Even recently, circular has come. These are the measures you have to take for washrooms, verandas, etc. Even measurements have been given. So that is one. Second, coming to policy. I think some disturbance is coming. Please unmute everybody. Yes. I will say it is the policy of the institution. Yes, our school is an inclusive school. To this, first, the teachers have to be trained to accept these students positively. Because teachers should not crib. They should not blame the students or the staff. They should not blame anybody. For that, proper training should be given to the teachers to accept these children. How to handle these children effectively should be taught to the teachers. Many of the schools, they don't know. So they think it is a burden. If you ask the teachers of Oman, Indian schools, they will say to extent they are happy. If you ask Indian school Muscat, they will say more than 75 teachers will say, send the children to my class, I will manage. And from 8th standard onwards, there are optional subjects and etc. Everything available. Use every exemptions, options for these students to manage. It will be very good. I will say, Gayatri ma'am, for inclusion, I think you should take a different platform. Why? Because it is a major subject. How inclusion can be practiced in the CBSE schools or the schools can be a different topic, whereby we can take from primary stage to upper stage with different subjects, how with the flow. Because this will not cater the need. But I will say the teacher school have to make mandatory, and school should have an open heart. Even wheelchair children come to the class should be accepted. And even last year, now at present, one student is going for engineering, that also IIT with a wheelchair. He cannot ride, he cannot walk. Even for the first year, go to washroom, child needs a help. Child speaks well, intellectual process very high. Scribe is writing for the exam for the child, but the child has reached IIT. It is possible, provided the heart is big for the teachers. It is the accommodation. So let us follow blindly, I will say, the accommodation, exceptions, regulations of CBSE or other any system, and every children will be inside the school. Inclusion will not become a challenge, but I will say training of the teachers are very must, because I am not against the teachers. It is because they don't know. They feel that what we will do. Because finally they are questioned by authority. What is the result, outcome of your class? They evaluate on the outcome. So if there is two sent children, automatically they are afraid of those. Now, what I have planned was, send children's evaluation is not put into the major criteria of evaluation of a teacher. It is taken positively. How effectively you are handling a send child in the classroom, they're getting plus points. So teachers become happy. The appraisal become more format. They become happy to accept these children. So they are not evaluated, put down on the basis of disability of a child in the classroom. No. That child is taken away and others are be evaluated. So certain time I have requested, teachers have requested me, Dr. Benny, why this child is not in the second category? Then I told, no, they don't, according to the test, they don't come to the second category because they are foundation error. It is not disability. So that also comes when the teachers become superpower. But I will say, inclusion is very easily can be managed, because if you take to the Indian schools in Oman, I'm proud to say, they know. There are hitches, I know, but still, it is happily done. Yes, thank you.
Dr. Veni, yesterday I was in one of the sessions for inclusioners only. I must say that there should be a separate session for what is the policy is, what is the policy gap and implementation of that particular policy, and then how schools are actually implementing those things, what are the implementation gap. The separate session can be done on this regard, because if we are talking about the happy curriculum, it is a different paradigm, and the inclusiveness is a different topic in a whole, I can say.
Sir, I agree with you partially, not fully. See, when my son, for example, simple example, my son is having a challenge and he's having everything different. Do you think that you will be happy with my son? No, I want my son to grow with the general population. Compete with them, do with them. But evaluation criteria is different. That we are teaching the teachers how to evaluate them. That is more better, I will say.
But there are certain actually learnings for students too. It's not only for the teachers. Our general teachers, our general students, the normal students, they should know the adaptability with those children also. So there are certain gaps into this. We are teaching to the teachers, but we are not teaching to our students too. If our students
I skipped that area. We are training the teachers also without the sent children how to incorporate this child's strength and limitation in the classroom. For example, if a wheelchair is coming to the classroom, how to impart, how to accommodate this child is being trained to this classroom students in prior without the presence of this disabled child. That also is there. Sorry. Thank you very much for reminding that. It has been done very well. And if you take in every classroom of ours, you will find sent children. And Pradeep sir, nearly 30, more than 20 students in Indian school Muscat is doing 10th or 12th examination per year.
Okay.
That much, it is a great practice which has been done, not only ISM, other Indian schools also. All are coming. Now inclusion has become a big landmark for Indian schools in Oman.
Even if we judge the schools for the listing of how the schools are doing, that should be their one of the major parameter to measure those schools. How the school is working on the inclusiveness, I must say.
Yes, sir. Now I will say one thing more. See, from 9th standard, the subject taught for these children, they have optional subjects. When it is taken according to their strength, automatically I will say they are scoring very high marks. Even we have disabled children who have got many symptoms, laurels to the school. So at present, seeing these things, parents accommodate that their children have a problem. They are ready to accept. Teachers are ready because laurels are brought to the school. Principal management is ready because with these children, we don't have any other problem. Challenges are there, I will not say. But with the cooperation of the school, students and the teachers, it is well practiced. I will say I am against separate school for them. Inclusion means literally inclusion. And it is, I will say, I am very proud that I could practice, or we could practice in Oman.
Yes,
this easily. Yeah, thank you. Sorry if
thank
I have
so
hurt
much,
anybody.
Sir. Thank you, sir. The next question is, happiness curriculum activities can be incorporated in lesson plans by teachers. Will that be a better way to bring curriculum to action in the real sense instead of just allotting a period?
See, what is told by the teacher, I will say, applaud the teacher. You have understood what is happiness. It should be incorporated in the subject taught. But CBSE is saying, especially CBSE is saying, or say, allot one or two period in a week, so that certain activities can be included also. So that is for activity-oriented program. Other one is happiness curriculum. Your subject is being taught. See, when we teach subject, see now, for example, I want to do some dancing. I want to teach the flock. I want to integrate one culture to the society. Max teacher is thinking. The teacher in her subject, she can never do that. Sometimes she may be have very good because of the, incorporating art in the classroom strategy. That is a more, again, it has come into picture. Integration of art in the curriculum. So she may, but I will say, always good to have one or two period in a week where exclusive period is kept. For example, we have music period, dance period, like that art period, happiness period, where these things are cultivated, extra activities. So for that, don't need of giving many period, maybe one period or two period according to the need. Because when certain regulations are told, we have to abide by. We have no other way. But I will say, best practice is bring happiness in the curriculum. But always, all teachers will not be able to bring it. So to cater everybody's need, they have made laws. So we have to abide by the laws. We have no other way. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. How to help mainstream teachers for changing their mindsets for inclusive education?
See, resistance is a common, anything change in the routine has a challenge. It's a common thing. I resist. For example, I am getting a new HOD. New curriculum is coming. Everywhere I will have hitches. It is adaptability. For example, now the order has come. Okay, tomorrow onwards, you are going to classroom 2. Then within 2 or 3 days, you are mentally set to do that. After doing that, slowly, slowly, you get immersed. You learn strategies. And when you get trained, you become a part of it. You enjoy it. Same way, I will say, to bring inclusion in the school, first of all, law should come. The school should say, okay, ours is inclusive school. Law is made. There is no exclusion. If a teacher wants to teach, we get many teachers. But if you stand with the students, the teachers have to say yes. Now, for example, X is, for example, I am taking example. I will not teach inclusive child, but I am a teacher. Now, I go to Gayatri Ma'am's school. Gayatri Ma'am says, are you ready to take inclusion child? I say, no. Dr. Benny, you look for better school. Thank you very much. Again, I am going to Pradeep sir. If they are going to 10 door and every school say, we have inclusive children, then what will I do? Okay, if I want a good job, good school, I have to change myself to get accommodated as a teacher. Same way, I will say, when the policies are made by everybody, inclusion become a policy and it will be without impartiality. Everybody will have inclusion. There is nothing wrong. It will become a part. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I'm not sure if you have highlighted this point in the prior questions, but just to reinstate.
Once again.
This is regarding happiness curriculum. Is it necessary to create a separate curriculum or can we accommodate this with existing curriculum?
It should go with existing curriculum. The methodology of teaching of each subject should change to the explorative. For example, you are going to bring art integration and you are going to bring happiness inside your each subjects. So that cannot be excluded. Only certain activities can be brought into some period, which has made, it was made as a mandatory now. So activities are included, but your teaching methodology should be based on happiness curriculum. That means you are going to be more explorative, more student-oriented, activity-oriented, and there is another curriculum also together with that art integration, That also you are good. When you mix everything, the students learn better, they understand everything, and everything you are practicing together with your subject. We just answered the same question before.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Yes.
The next question is regarding having a sent child in class. We have two related questions.
Okay.
Firstly, should we design a separate activity for the child during our happiness class?
I will say no. The child has to get integrated partially or how much the child can. But always see that when we make a curriculum or activity for the happiness, it should be almost all the students should integrate partially. Involvement should be there. Now, I think the person who has asked doesn't have much knowledge about the inclusive classroom. I think so. I may be wrong. If you come to inclusive school, you can see in all the assemblies, all the activities, all children of inclusive will be there on the stage. Other children are very happy to accommodate them because they will be given a partial duty of doing that, and they will do meticulously, very beautifully. I remember, again, I am bringing this one. Simple example, I have an autistic child who has reached now class 10 now. No, I know, I cannot say now I have. I'm not with the system. When I asked, when the child was fifth standard, the assembly teacher, moderator, the music teacher, please include her in the music. He had a big challenge. He was saying it may not be possible, whether he will do. But I told, please add, you have to add. Finally, he got the intimation from the vice principal, please add this child, let the child be in the group. Now I will say, without this child, there is no program in the school. The child is, when the child comes to the stage, we never see the disability of this child. That much strong the child is. We have to tell the teacher this is a sent child. So that much is a goodness. Even I remember we were giving, we have a prayer through mic and assembly hall. Through the mic, sometimes we bring disabled children to the mic to read the prayer or maybe thought for the day. How beautifully they prepare and do, you know? And it, when they are doing it, it has without anything, we literally get into that prayer mode because they do with the heart. So don't think that anything and everything for the sent should be separate. Nothing needed. Just accommodate them slowly, slowly. They will become a part of you. Only thing is you should have a thought process is there with you. And when you actually see that they are also getting involved. Slowly, slowly, they will get involved. And I will say, they will be the best follower of you teachers. They will go with you everywhere. They will do anything and everything, whatever you ask, the same spirit. Others will have exceptions. They will say this problem, that problem, etc. No, these 10 children never will say excuse to you. They will be 100% cooperative with you. That's my experience. So please don't exclude them. Don't make anything separate. Make for the classroom, thinking the limitation of strength of your class, make a curriculum, make an activity, this child also will get included. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Actually, I think the next question was related and you almost answered it, but just to share it with the audience, the participant had asked how the happiness curriculum can be beneficial to send children. So do you want to add something to it?
See, without any serious intervention, if you are practicing happy curriculum, sent children will be getting involved because they love activity oriented than theoretical. And happiness curriculum purely go with the, what is a activity oriented, engagement oriented programs. So automatically they will get immersed in themselves. Yes, ma'am. Please add others also.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. This is one question from Raj Vineet. He's shared a brief profile that he's a contemplative mindfulness practitioner and facilitator by passion. Currently, the person is at crossroads in life in terms of pursuing professional knowledge and certification around mental health and well-being. The person is seeking your suggestions, sir, for some focused courses which would help the candidate become a certified mental health professional.
Purely personal thing. So ask him to contact my, my number is there, Gmail is there, please contact. Personal, just a purely personal matter. Because it needs elaborative discussions. Because I have to know the strength, limitations, background knowledge of the person to help the child person. So you can just note down my email ID, or this is my my mobile number together with the WhatsApp number. I will be available. I will answer you, definitely, sir. Anybody can contact me for anything, no problem. Related to this area, especially mental disability area, you can at any time, you can contact me. I will be at your disposal. I guarantee that.
Thank you so much, sir. The next question is, the child may be happy in my class, but if he is not involved in other class, then how do we help such children?
See, here we have to look from two dimensions. From child side, from the teacher side. What is a block between me and the child is, me and the teacher is the first thing. So if I like the teacher, I do very well. If I don't like the teacher, I don't do things. I don't cooperate. I will say, we have to work out, especially student, teacher coordinator, others have to work out personally without any grudge. No evaluation of the teacher, no evaluation of the child. Just to find out what is the marginal gap between them. Then work out, unite them. I will not say, if I am happy with X, I have to be happy with Y. Individual differences are there. That is personal to the teacher and personal to the child also. All will not be happy with everything. And for example, today I am happy with seeing a movie. Tomorrow I am not happy with seeing a movie. I want to see a drama. So individual differences will be there. Choices of indifference will be there according to the situation, moment, etc. For example, I like the dance of a particular child. I like yoga of a particular child. I like a speech of a particular child. I have the right to have a choice also. But I get involved maximum. Individual differences will be there, margins will be there. We cannot say X should be same as Y. No, if you just take the subject itself, a student who is very good in maths, it is not necessary the child should be very good in, Malayalam also, or maybe language, regional language also. There can be individual differences, but try to fill the gap. Work out with both the category, individual and the teacher. So first is better to approach the child. What makes you not cooperating with the teacher? What is your observation? Do you face any difference? You can be confident with me. I will not share with anybody. I will try to help you win the confidence, build a rapport where the special educators, counselors, or the coordinating teachers can work out who is good with the child. Then work with the teacher. There is no judgment. Don't say the teacher is bad, good. No. Teachers, this methodology is not adapted by this child. So you can tell the teacher, teacher, can you cooperate this methodology also? But in every classroom, there will be differences of opinion. It is natural. Please don't judge any teachers based on that. But authorities, please work on strategic movement to incorporate everyone together. That is my advice for that. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Is it possible to share the model of a happiness curriculum of any other school?
To me, I am not able to share. You can request different schools, or you will have a partner schools, everybody. Everything you can opt, or you work on a module, you send to me, I will tell which can be practiced, which is not easily practical. I am not ready to compare, because all the schools are getting ready with the modules. So it is not the time to share what is being practiced. It is the time to observe what is being practiced. Evaluate, and modification should be made, then only we can share. Before that, we cannot share anything. And I am not a criterion to share anything, because I am only a person who can impart knowledge. Okay.
I can add to this some one or two models I can project from the Delhi government. Certain models they have actually presented, which has been actually working in their state government schools. That I can present.
Good, sir. Thank you very much. I think Gayatri ma'am, note that our teachers are receiving the models, so that it's a good sign.
Sure, sir.
It's already implemented schools.
True, sir. We'll compile everything and we'll send to that, share with the teachers.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. One last question to take from the chat box. Is there any checklist to assess emotional quotient of a child?
There are checklists available. Please write personal to me. I will try to help you. These things cannot be commonly shared, but screening test can be given. I think I will discuss with Gayatri ma'am, and they will reach to you. Otherwise, you can surf through the Google. You will get a checklist available in the system available. And whatever you feel good, let me know. If you want any guidance from me, I'm ready to help you. No objection. Whatever you feel good or whatever you are practicing, let me know. Then I will say this area of this tool is good for this area. Everything can be discussed. No problem. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. And we come to the end of Q&A. I would like to thank Dr. Benny, sir, for sharing your experience and knowledge with us. Over to the admin team.
I request and invite Pradeep sir to take over and to give your feedback of the session.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Gayatri ma'am, and thank you to all my interns to taking the QA from the chat box and helping us to go around QA session. Thanks for that. It was a very wonderful session, and I thanks all of us, of course, all those who are present here. Around 200 participants had participated today, and very actively and patiently they were listening to our session. It was very nice session, and Dr. Benny has covered certain good points into that. I will include some of the things which I found very much interesting. There was a discussion regarding how the parent, teacher, and child in a single you can say inclusiveness consideration. They should discuss their problems, and they should come out with those challenges, and they should come out with those solutions. Schools should incorporate these kind of activities. Of course, they cannot go with their on the daily basis, but weekly, or I can say 15 days, they should include these kind of activities. And secondly, how he has framed out the environment, that happiness environment, how to implement that happiness environment by the way of activities, by way of course, we are doing various things in co-curricular activities. We are doing so many things with, you can say, songs or national sports day or school sports day, annual meets, annual fest. We are doing this. But there are still certain gaps left out which we need to address. And for those kind of things, happy curriculum is, of course, one way. We must actually include and try to implement this thing. Anything and anything left out or anything queries in regard to this, you should connect to us also, Atmanirbhar Bharat team also, and also Benny Johnson. He will be helping us for the same, for any of the thing, of course, in regard to implementation, in regard to curriculum or in regard to any of the guidance for happy curriculum. Now I request Gayatri Madam to actually present a gratitude certificate to our resource person who has given a very great insightful you can say his understanding and his learnings to us, by which we can incorporate this learning to our schools and not only in India, also overseas, Muscat, Oman, and those who are joined us from various other countries too. Thank you. Gayatri Madam, please do the needful.
Thank you, sir. Benny sir, we request you to kindly stop sharing the screen because our interns would like to share the token of gratitude to you.
Okay, stop sharing. Went off. Okay, stop share. Okay, done.
I request the intern team to kindly share the certificate of gratitude to Dr. Bedi sir.
I request the host, if you could make Akila's co-host. She has got the certificate.
Can she switch on her video? I'm not able to see her at all. Yes. Yes, Akila. I request you to kindly share the certificate of gratitude to Dr. Bedi sir. On behalf of Atmanirbhar Bharat, R2B and Prakramika Institute, we extend our heartfelt gratitude and thanks to our honorable resource person, Dr. Benny Verghese, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. Thank you, Atmanirbhar Bharat.
Thank you. Thank you for being with us and thank you for mentoring us and guiding us for the same. And this was a very insightful session. All were actually excited to go for some more sessions into this.
Thank you.
Thank you, Akila.
Gayatri Madam, should we proceed next?
Yes, sir. We come to an end of this beautiful session. Now I request Pradeep sir to kindly give the closing note.
Okay. Thank you, Gayatri Madam. It's been wonderful, of course, on the holiday hours. We are sitting around, you can say, since 11 o'clock to 2. It's been 3 hours and we are listening. And you all are listening very actively and patiently to our session. A very highly informative session. I can see on the chat box around, you can say, hundreds of chats are going around. And whatever the queries are there. I must appreciate you all to be actively participating in this. Once we floated this actually, this particular advertisement for the session, we got around 450 requests. So this is how, then we closed some of the, yesterday night, we closed the registration. Although due to Sunday or due to holiday, might be some people were busy in some other task because on Sundays, we got usually the times for that. But still, we have a 2,200 people on board. And all those who are left over, I must say that we will be taking other sessions also on their request by the mail. And even I floated the Google form too, so that they can share those details by the way of Google form. And our intern team will be sharing a feedback form too for the same that how the session was and what else they required from us so that we can help them out in regard to happiness curriculum and how to implement those things. Coming on to closing note, thank you all. But I required some of the help from you people because you are into the teaching fraternity and faculty from all the colleges. Atmanirbhar Bharat team is going with one of the research which is we are doing with the school and school teachers across India, across world. Around 200 schools and 200 teachers have been contacted for the same, but we require around 2,000 to 6,000 of teachers to be actively participate in that. That particular survey is for half an hour. So I request all those who are interested for being a participatory to that particular research work, please join us. I will be sharing those details by mail along with the certificates. All the participants will be getting the certificates for the today's session and other details of the research work by with that mail only. So all those who are interested, please let us know so that Atmanirbhar Bharat team can contact you for that research work. And yes, for this happy curriculum session, if you require any other queries into that, or if you require any more sessions, please write us by the way of feedback or by the way of mail ID. You people are having those mail IDs. I thank you all and I congratulate you all. Of course, you might have got some of the insights with the introductory part. And Dr. Benny sir, thanks for so much enlightening session. And we got to know actually how to implement or how to incorporate happiness environment in our school. Firstly, we have to create that environment. Then only we can create the curriculum. So, within the ecosystem, the parents, teachers, students, and of course, other ecosystems are also working into that. In cohesion, in comparison to all those ecosystems, we can implement those things. Thanks for all. Thank you. Namaskar.
Thank you, Nagayatri. Thank you,
Pradeep sir. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Yes, Pradeep sir, you wanted to tell anything?
No. Get along. You can proceed next.
Thank you, sir. Happiness curriculum focuses on process rather than outcome. Let us wholeheartedly do it. What powerful statements they were, and a lot of takeaways for all of us in this session. We would be conducting more such sessions. We'll plan for it. And for any queries, please do write to anbws07@gmail.com. We have shared the email link in the chat box also. The certificate of participation, the PDF curriculum, the video links, and all other resource materials will be shared with you shortly. Kindly give us a couple of days. We will be doing it. So, thank you all so much for joining us. Thanks to Dr. Benny sir for your great insight, sharing your knowledge with us. And our sincere thanks to our chief guest, Vasugi ma'am, for being with us today and inaugurating. And our special thanks to Pradeep sir, our convener, Atmanirbhar Bharat, for giving us this platform and helping us with this knowledge sharing. Thank you. Thank you all. Namaste.
Thank you. I must add on to this, the vote of thanks should also go for our interns, Mr. Somnath Mishra, Ms. Akshaya Narasimhan, Ms. Kirtana, Ms. Vaishnavi, Ms. Lakshmi Priya, Ms. Roop Sala, Manu Mohan, and Akhila. These are the people, those who are working at backstages and making our team effort and making our sessions enlightful and grateful, reaching out to all the people across India, across world. Thank you for your cooperation, and thank you my core team members, those who are here, those who are present here, for making our Atmanirbhar Bharat initiatives going across all institutions and all the corners of the world. Thank you for the same.
Thank you sir.
Shall I end the session, sir?
Please.
Thank you.
Thank you,
ma'am. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.